Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. In this video, I'm going to study about types of indexing. Now, I have already made a video on indexing in DBMS. If you have not checked it out already, I would suggest you watch that video before watching this video to understand types of indexing better. But in short, why is indexing used? Indexing is used to optimize the performance of DB by minimizing the number of disk accesses required when a query is processed. Basically, when you have a huge main table and you want to reduce the time to access a particular record, we use index files. And this is the structure of an index file. We have a search key, which is basically a primary key, and then we have the second field is data reference, basically a pointer which is pointing to that particular block. So this is why indexing is used. Indexing is used to reduce time to access a particular record. Now these are types of indexing: primary, clustering, secondary. Let's understand first the primary. Primary is basically when you have primary keys in your table. Now this is your main table. Now dense. In primary we have two types, dense and sparse. Dense is basically the number of entries in index table is same as the number of entries in main table. As I already said, there are two types of tables considered. One is your index table, another is your main table. Now if your main table has three rows, obviously when you have three rows you actually won't have an index table for it, but index table is actually used when you have huge tables. But just for example, if there are three rows in your main table, your index table will also have three rows. Okay, and it has many records, but your index table will have only two columns, roll number and pointer, and this table will have quite many columns. Now in case of sparse, we do not have same number of rows in your index table. Index table does not have same number of rows as the main table. Okay, now your main table will be divided into blocks, block 1, block 2. So 1 to 10, the rows from 1 to 10 will be considered into block 1, from 11 to 20 will be considered into block 2, and similarly all of this. And here in your index table, only the first row from that particular block will be considered. So 1, 11, 21, 31. Now if I ask you my index table to give me the record number 15, how will it find? So it will, now it wants 15. Now we know that 15 will be between 11 and 21. And in this case, the main table is ordered. Now what does ordered mean? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, all of these will be in order, in proper order. It's not like 10 will be above 5 or something like that. They are in proper order. So when I ask my index table to find row number 15, it will know that it is between 11 and 21. So it will go inside. It will check the pointer for this row, and it will check in this block, and it will return me value for 15, for primary key 15. When do we use dense indexing? When our main table is not ordered, when main table is unordered. So because, as I already said, sparse will only work when it is in order, is in proper order. If your 10 will be above 5 or 10 will be above 20, this method cannot work, and hence every particular row in main table should be in the index table in case of dense, because it is unordered. I hope that is clear. Now this is the second type, which is clustering. Now in clustering, it is in case of non-unique key. Now what does that mean? Non-unique key, as in we do not have one primary key. So such as your table has a department ID. Your table has department ID, which can be same for many students. So in that case, our index table will only have department IDs, okay, which can be same for different students. So every department ID will have one particular pointer, which will point to one block which has all the rows of this particular department. Okay, and these are considered as clusters. So you need to understand that clustering is in case of non-unique key. So why non-unique? As I already said, the students, as every student, as many students can have one particular department ID. So this is where clustering is used. Third type is secondary. Now this is a two-level indexing. This is basically two-level indexing. So this is my primary level indexing. So over here I have segregated my index table like this: 1, 101, 201, 301, 401. Now Now this will point to another index table. This will not point to main table, but this will point to another index table, and this index table will again be will have categorization. This index table will have another categorization like 1, 11, 21, 91, and then this one will point to data blocks. So over here we have our records 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 10. This is our main table. These are our data blocks. Okay, so here we have two index tables. So here we have two level indexing. So this is primary level indexing. Your index table will be in a RAM. Okay, and this secondary level index, this is a second level index table, and this will be in hard disk, and these are our data blocks. So I hope this is clear. If you like the video, please subscribe to the channel. Thank you.